Hey, it's Saturday on LA But Great, and this is Tracy. This week's question comes to us from Nicole in Berlin. And what a question it is. Nicole, thank you so much for your submission to LA But Great and being our contest winner. I have been doing pretty much nothing but thinking about how to respond to your question all week. It's a wonderful question that really made me think, and I'm going to read it to y'all, then I'm going to try to give my response to it. But I think the other outlaters gave tremendous responses this week and actually kind of covered everything I was going to say, but I hopefully can add a few things to it. So here's the question. How can LGBT activists in general from the Western world, and especially the queer YouTube community, support and create alliances with LGBT people in countries other than North America and Europe who face discrimination, persecution, punishment, and sexual harassment for being gay and for being active in the fight to improve LGBT rights in their country? When I first read the question, I felt a little helpless. I felt like I do when I think about women's rights, especially in third world countries. I felt like I'm nothing but a tear in a salted sea. There's nothing that I can do to remedy this enormous situation. And, you know, it's difficult to support people in countries that have oppressive governments and have oppressive rules against LGBT people as an individual person. But listening to some of the collaborators this week, it really reminded me that we are a community, and sometimes communities can come together to help others. One thing that was Jim from Georgia mentioned was Hillary Clinton's speech to the UN. She talked about human rights and gay rights as encompassed by human rights. And I think that's a start that the United States and the leadership right now that we have with Barack Obama may want to expand human rights around the world. And the other thing I thought is the United States really isn't the moral compass or the moral authority to help LGBT people in other countries, because we don't even have rights here in our country for LGBT people. Just a little side story, Karen and I spent the afternoon in an attorney's office trying to get our finances and our survivorship benefits together in case one of us passes away. And we realized today in a very big way that we have to pay thousands of dollars more to have the same rights as a married couple just in the United States. And we're supposedly, you know, the beacon of freedom, the a country that likes to spread democracy. And here we are denying basic rights to our citizens. We also have a religious community in our country, the evangelical Christian community, one of which Jim from Ohio talked about. Rick Warren and his group actually sending out missionaries to Uganda to help spread the Kill the Gays bill. So I think the United States does not really, we're not progressive on gay rights. We're more progressive than, say, Saudi Arabia and Iran, but we're not much more progressive than you know, I think even Venezuela is more progressive on gay rights than we are. So we really have no moral ground to stand on in that arena. But as individuals, I think the internet, and I think Jim from Ohio hit on this, the internet is really key to starting a global movement. I mean, when you look at just the last few years, anytime a country has civil unrest, the government shuts down the internet. China's done it. Syria's done it. Egypt has done it. I think that this is our key. YouTube, and other social media, Facebook. I have a friend in Jordan on Facebook. This is our key to really making incremental and small changes in countries that can help our communities. We can become active locally and grassroots organizations, and that spreads. And I guess, you know, as again, I was thinking about this question this week, and I thought, you know, once again, I'm just a tear in a salted sea. I'm not going to make a difference. But a friend of mine sent just a general email and had some interesting facts in it. One thing I didn't know is that the Amazon River empties into the Atlantic Ocean, and it empties with such a volume that about 50 miles out, you can dip your cup into the sea and get fresh water because it just inundates the ocean. And maybe that's what we can do as collectively as an LGBT community, is just grassroots organization, keep working on it, building and just inundate our governments, inundate our families by being out, that we deserve the same rights as everybody else, and you know, we just deserve the same existence as everybody. Women still don't have rights in the majority of the world. And I think the LGBT community is still struggling with that as well. But I just think there's hope with all of us just collectively putting ourselves out there, coming out to our families, coming out to our communities, and just showing that we are the same as everybody else, and our differences are not something to be afraid of. So I don't know if this answers your question, Nicole, but I really thank you for presenting it because it really made me think a lot this week. Everyone have a great week, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.